of your vision, what is a loyalty and what is a citizenship. And my proposal was everybody must sign some declaration of loyalty to our country and your commitment to serve in army or alternative service, and to understand that Israel is a Jewish country, in loyalty to the flag, to the anthem, and everybody who signed on this declaration, he can be a citizen, and it's really very open for anybody. Also, we have some problem with the Jewish Orthodox community. I think that Natural Carter, for example, to take a part even today in some conference in Tehran about Holocaust, and they deny our right for our country and the Zionism, they cannot be a citizens of Israel. And this is very important part of this plan. And one more point, it's very important to understand. It's impossible to impose any political plan, any political solution before achieving two main issues, two main problems for Israelis and Palestinians. What is the main issue for Israelis? It's security. What is the main issue for Palestinians? It's economy. Any attempt to impose political plan before achieving security and economy really destined to fail. It's impossible, and what cried Shimon Peres for the last 13, 14 years, to bring political solution before we have security and economy. Comprehensive global solution must based on real knowledge of these three misconceptions and this principle of security and prosperity before political solution. What we can do today in according to the Palestinian problem? First of all, also today we see a big fight in the Palestinian society. Yesterday, three childs of one officer were killed in Gaza Strip. And we see really the fight between more moderate and people and extremic Hamas people, moderate and secular part of Palestinian society is Hamas. First of all, we must make right partners. I don't think that Abu Mazen is the right partner. I think that he is a big obstacle. I know very good the political map in Palestinian authority. I think there are new people, there is a new generation, the people who grew up in the Europe and United States, the educated universities in Europe and United States, they're ready to fight Hamas, and their biggest obstacle is Abu Mazen. Abu Mazen, he's excellent for declarations, but when he must deliver the goods, he's incompetent. It's our experience for the last 3-4 years with Abu Mazen. I think that we must wait with new generation and give them a chance. Because also, the Palestinians, the left, the Arabs, they know very well ethics, both the disputes in our society, and I don't understand why we don't use the disputes and disagreements in their society. And today, I think it's more that it's a fight between Israelis and Palestinians. It's a fight between, as I said before, between two civilizations, two approaches to the future world. And we have, even between Arab countries or Muslim countries, we have real excess of ego that is Iran is the main link, also Syria, Hezbollah, Hamas, and from the other side, on the other hand, we have Egypt, Jordan, maybe Saudi Arabia, we have some part of Palestinian society, and we must use this situation, we must deal with this situation. We must understand that any agreement, any commitments in Judea and Samaria, we must coordinate with the Jordanian kingdom and Gaza Strip with the Egyptians. The second, to strengthen this new generation